Now let's move on and get you some more market opinions. CNBC TV 18's Sonia Shenoy caught up with Gautam Sinha Roy and Manish Santhalia of Motilal Oswal Asset Management to find out what they're betting on at the moment.
How much India is going to get impacted is our trade links with the European Union as well as UK, and that will have a ramification on our currency as well as our GDP if the global slowdown was to happen due to the Brexit event. I think we can safely say that for FY17, FY18, we could shave off 10 to 20 bips of GDP from our earlier estimates, 7.7 going down to 7.6, for FY17, 7.9 going down to 7.7, 7.8. That is all about it. And so, apart from export-related sectors where they, you know, companies are deriving revenues in foreign exchange, or you're importing, that your cost of production is involving some sort of an import component, or you have liabilities in foreign exchange. These are the sectors which are going to get impacted. If you're selling in rupees and buying, producing in rupees, the reporting currency is rupees, I don't see too much of an impact, and that is why, you know, with this uncertainty and good rains, if we were to get that sort of a situation, I think it's a win-win for India. It's a good time to buy.
Okay, it's a good time to buy. So let's drill it down to specific stocks, because there's so much that's buzzing today. Gautam, hi, afternoon. You know, pharma seems to have come back into action. In fact, Lupin, Cipla, all of them looking very good. Auro Pharma. In your Motilal Oswal Focus 35 fund, you do have Lupin. What's the sense you're getting about whether this sector has come back into the buyer's list, and what would your prognosis be here on?
I think the sector had become very cheap over the last 1 year because of all the US FDA issues, which will eventually get resolved, and somewhere the buying is starting preceding that before the issues get resolved. Another thing which is helping is the US dollar depreciation, which people are believing will happen. So I think net-net prognosis is very good. Valuations are extremely attractive. It's one of the large cap sectors where valuations are very attractive today. So from that perspective, future returns in pharma from a 3-year perspective should be really good, is what we believe. We continue to own some of the frontline names in pharma, as well as a few mid-cap names, which we really like.
Okay, so that's...